Hello students, good morning everybody. Today we are going to start the new lesson. Lesson number 7, experiments with water. Okay children, this is our new lesson. In this lesson we are going to do many more activities, okay? That I will show you at the end of this lesson. That you try in your home children. Before that I am going to tell some things, some interesting topics in this lesson. Then what we are going to do as an activity and also they said about some of the stories, okay? That only we are going to see here. Page number 60, okay? All of you take page number 60. What floats, what sinks? Aisha was, the first topic is what floats, what sinks. Aisha was waiting for dinner. Today, Ammi was making her favorite food, puri and spicy potatoes. Aisha, a girl, okay? She is waiting for dinner. Today, Ammi was making her favorite food. What she is making? Favorite food, which mean by? For her favorite food is puri and potatoes, okay? She is preparing. Who is preparing? Her mom, Aisha's mom. Aisha watched as her mother rolled out the puri and put it in the hot oil. What she watched, children? She watched that her mother rolled out the puri and put it in the hot oil. She saw that at first the puri sank to the bottom of the pan as the puff of the puri came up and started floating on the oil. Did you ever notice this, children? If you ever noticed this before, hereafter after watching this video, what you have to do is, if your mom is preparing puri in your home, you should have to watch it, okay children? You should have to watch the puri, how it sinks. First it sinks into the oil and then it is puffed off. So after this video you have to watch how your mommy is preparing puri, okay children? One puri did not puff off and did not float like others. Seeing this, Aisha took some dust and rolled it into a ball. So, while preparing all the puris, but one puri did not puff off. So, what she did means, she took up the dust, which means by a mixture of flour and liquid and rolled into a ball. She flattened it again and put it in a bowl of water. What she did? She put it in a bowl of water. Bottom and stayed there itself. If you put the puri in oil means, what happened children? It sank first and then it puffed off and came out of a dish puri, isn't it? But one puri, isn't it? It does not happen. So what he did means, what she did means, she took that puri and she poured a mixture of dust and rolled it in a ball. And what she did? She put into the water. And what did happen, children? It fell down water and stayed there itself. Think what would happen if that comes a question for her. Aisha put a puffed puri in a bowl of water. Would it sink or float? The puri would float. Okay, children, Aisha put a puffed puri in a bowl of water. She put what puri, children? Puffed puri, the puri which is prepared for to eat. That puri, what she did? She put in a bowl of water. Would it sink or did it float, children? The puri float. Okay. Second question. You put a steel plate on water. Would it sink or float? What would happen to your spoon? If I put the steel plate carefully on water, it would float. The spoon would sink. Okay. Listen, children. These are all the activities I am going to do. Okay. Thus, I am telling you now. These are all the activities I am going to do it at the end of this video. Okay. You should have to watch that also. Would the cap of a plastic bottle sink or float in water? On water? Yes, the cap of a plastic bottle will float on water. This and all I'm going to do as an activity. In the evening, Aisha went for a bath. She had just come out with her mother called. Aisha, you have dropped the soap in the water again. Take it out and put it in the suitcase. Aisha was in a hurry and the suitcase fell out of her hands. It started floating on water. Aisha gently put the soap in the suitcase. She saw that the case continued to float even with the soap in it. This is also important to children, okay? Have you seen that something float on water by other sink? Think how this happens, children. Something is floating, something is sinking. How does it happen? as it are observed that certain things float on water while others sink. Everything displays water equal to its volume. The water, if everything displays, for whatever you are doing experiment that depends upon the displaces water that equals to its volume, children. Whatever quantity of amount we are taking water, that depends, that is equal to its volume. Okay, that is equal to its volume. So if the displaced water, what we call displaced water, it is more than the weight of the thing. Whatever we are putting, it is weight more than the weight of the thing, means the thing is float. The thing will float, otherwise it is sink. Okay, children, what I am saying, do you understand what I am saying here? If the displaced water is more than the weight of a thing, then the tiny, then the thing floats, otherwise it sinks in water. Okay. Here, listen, we have like poem. Why, oh why, a wooden boat in water will float, but in wood it will sink. Why does this happen? Let me think. Remember, yes, children, the displaced water is more than the weight of a thing, means what will happen, children? The thing floats, otherwise it sinks. Okay, an iron ship will also float through. It's much heavier than my boat. But a needle like a leaf, as a pin, will sink like pin. Why does this happen? Let me think. Okay, this is all about, it says about the displaces water that is equal to the quantity of, is more than the weight of a thing, then the tiny float, otherwise it sinks in water. Okay, children, next, do this and find out. This is also a type of experiment that we have to do as an activity. Okay, children, we will do this as an activity. Next topic is, isn't it magic? When Aisha woke up in the morning, Ami had fever. Abu made some tea and went to give medicines to Ami. He told Aisha, you boil eggs, also put some salt in the water. One day what happened is, Aisha woke up in the morning, okay? Her mother had fever. Then she called Abu, made some tea and wanted to give some medicines to his mother. He told Aisha to boil eggs. What he told to Aisha, children? To boil eggs. Also put some salt in the water. Also he said to put some salt in the water. Aisha took the water in pot. By mistake, she put too much salt in the water. She saw the eggs at the bottom of the pot come up a little and start to float in water. Did you ever notice it, children? While oil egg is boiling in a pan, this also you should have to watch when your mother cooks, okay? Take some water in a glass, put a lemon in it. Now keep putting salt in the water, half a spoon at a time. Were you able to float your lemon in water? Yes, the lemon started to float on water, okay? So, you can try in your own, children. See, take some water in a glass. You have to take some water in a glass and you have to put a lemon on it. Now keep putting salt in the water, then half a spoon at a time. Then you're able to float your lemon in water. Yes, the lemon started to float on water. What do you think the lemon floated in? Salty water. Because yes, adding salt, the water became thicker and thus lemon started floating. How it floating, children? Because we are adding salt, isn't it? If you add salt, means the water becomes thicker and thus the lemon started floating. This is the reason for lemon to float in the glass. And then we are going to discuss, and then one more activity, children. What dissolved, what did not? This is also one of the activity that I am going to show you. Okay, for the things salt, soil, chalk powder, 1 spoon milk, and oil. Okay, we are going to do with an activity. Dissolve, did it dissolve or not? What happened after keeping for 2 minutes? We are going to do with an activity. This I will show you at the end of this video, children, and we will discuss about this questions also. Then, while doing the experiment, Aisha and Ami had an argument. Aisha felt that after stirring in the oil dissolved in water, Ami did not agree. He said, look, the tiny yellow oil drops can still be seen in the water. Aisha said, let's wait for some time and then see. While doing the experiment, Aisha and Ami had an argument. Okay, what argument they had? Aisha said, if you put oil in a water, it sinks. What she said? It sinks. But Ami says, it is wrong. It does not sink. See, the oil drops, the tiny yellow oil drops can be still even in the water. So Aisha said, let's wait for some time and then we will see. Do you think the oil got dissolved in the water? Why do you think so?
I think
that the oil did not dissolve in water. Oil floating on water surface, maybe you think so. Okay, yes, it is correct, children. Yes, if you put the oil in the water, it does not dissolve in water. Oil floating on water surface, maybe you think so. And then also one more, raising drops. Aisha put two drops of oil on the lid of a tiffin box. Next to that, she put two drops of water and two drops of sugar solution. She tilted the lid. She saw some drops slide down quickly, while some that left behind. See, this is a picture that shows like this, children. This also I show you in an activity. Okay, children. The last topic is, where did the water go? One day, Aisha mother put some water to boil on the stove for making tea. She got busy with something and forgot about it. When she remembered and came to check, she found very little water left in the pan. Okay, what is it, children? One day, Aisha mother put some water to boil, okay, on the stove for making tea. But she got busy and forgot that. After she came to see that, when she remembered and came to check, very little water is left in the pan. How does it happen, children? See, where did the water go? The answer is, the water evaporated and turned into vapor. Okay, how did it, children? The water and all evaporated and turned into vapor. Why did Chitti Babu and Chinna Babu keep their mango jelly in the sun? This is the story about, in the last lesson I said to you, my children, they prepared Mamani Chandra, isn't it? Two brothers prepared Mamani Chandra. What did they? They kept their mango jelly in the sun. Why they kept the mango jelly in the sun, children? Because the mango jelly, if they keep the mango jelly in the sun, the water from the jelly could evaporate. For that only they kept dried in the sun. Okay, children, and the last question. At your house, what things are made by drying in the sun? Potato chips, pepper, pickles, and sabudana pepper. Okay, these are all the things that we used to do, dry them well in the sun. Okay, children, this is end of your lesson. You have some more, you have activities to do after this video. Just watch it and try to do your home, children. Today's assignment is, you have to write, fill in the blanks, score, false, smash, circle, order, note, question, answer, in your care. Okay, children, this is the end of your lesson. Thank you. See, children, here we are going to do an activity based on float and sink. Okay, we are going to do with a steel plate. Okay, children, I'm going to put a steel plate on water. Okay, children, observe it and find whether it is float or sink. See, children, steel plate is floating on the water, isn't it? Next, I'm going to put spoon on water. Okay, children, see how it will be. Spoon is sinking, isn't it? So what is the difference, children? Steel is floating, the spoon is sinking. How it happened, children? Because we observed that, I already said to you in the class, that certain things float on water while others sink. Everything displaces water equal to its volume, isn't it? So here the displaced water is more than the weight of a thing. If it is, then the thing floats, otherwise it sinks in water. Okay, children, next we are going to see some more activity to check about float and sink. Now we are going to compare with soap and soap case. Okay, children, see, here the soap. I'm going to put the soap in this water. Okay, what you can observe from this, children? Soap is sinking, isn't it? Next, we are going to place soap in this soap case. Okay, children, and then after that, what you are going to do? We are going to put this
water. Put the soap case in this water. Okay, what you can observe from the children? See, the soap with soap case is floating, isn't it? So from this you can clearly understand that soap sinks in the water. The soap with the soap case floats in the water. Why it happens, children? When the soap gets into the water, it's high weight, so it's sink. When the soap is in the soap case, air is filled within the soap case, so it floats. That was the difference. Okay, children, do you all understand? Next, we are going to see another activity. The same thing based on float and sink. Okay, children, see, this is a iron nail and this is a pin. Okay, safety pin. We are going to see whether it is a float or sink. Shall we test it, children? I am going to put iron nail in water. See, it sink, isn't it? Then I am going to put safety pin in water. It is also sink. Then see what it is. It is a matchstick. What it is, children? It is a matchstick. I am going to put matchstick in water. See, children, it floats, isn't it? It floats. So this is also one more activity that based on nail, pin and matchsticks, that is in your page number 62. Okay, children, you have your tableau column, the things to be put in water. Okay, you have lot of things. I showed you just one thing, children. Try this in your home and fill this tableau column in page number 62. See, children, I have showed you about iron nail, pin, matchstick, isn't it? These are all the things that you have to do this in your home. What is the first one, children? Empty bowl. Okay, after putting in 6 to 7 small pebbles one by one, you have to observe it whether it is a float or sink. Okay, these two I have shown you. And after that, there is an empty plastic bottle with its lid closed. What you have to do? You have to put that only empty plastic bottle, okay, with its lid closed. And you have to observe it. And then bottle half filled with water. The second one is, what you have to do? You have to put this bottle which is half filled with water, okay. And you have to observe it. And then the third one is, you have to do the activity with the bottle full of water and find out the answer, and you have to fill this column. The next one is, you have to do with the aluminium foil. Okay, if you do it, otherwise leave it, children. And then soap cake. Okay, I have showed you with the soap cake. And the last one is a piece of ice. Okay, and then after you have to fill this blanks, children. The iron nail sank in water, but the cutlery floated. I think this happened because iron nail could displace less amount of water than what was displaced by the cutlery. Okay, the empty plastic bottle floated on water. The bottle filled with water sank because the filled bottle could displace less amount of water. Then the third one, the aluminium foil floated when it was spread out. When pressed tightly into a ball, it sank. This may have happened because aluminium foil spread out could displace more water compared to its weight. Okay, children, we have to do this activity and we have to fill this blank in page number 62. The next activity is about what dissolved, what did not. Okay, children, we are going to see with the things salt, oil, okay, and also we have chalk powder also. Okay, children, two more things you have to do with soil and milk that you try in your home, children. I am going to show you with the salt and also with the oil. Okay, children, take a bowl with water. Now I am going to put some salt into it. Okay, what am I going to do, children? I am going to put some salt into it. See, salt. What it happens, children? It dissolves in water, isn't it? Salt is dissolves in water. After you observing for 2 minutes, water and salt got mixed together completely. Water removed it transparent. Okay, children, this is one activity I showed you based on salt. Shall we see with this? Now I'm going to show with this the oil. Okay, children, see, this is a oil and this is a cup of water. Okay, what you have to do, we have to check by putting one drop of oil in this water. What you can able to identify, children? Is this dissolved in water, children, or it floats? Okay, see, by this you can clearly see that oil is floating. Oil is floating on the water. Okay, children, so oil floats on the surface of water. You can try this in your home, children. I showed you about salt and oil. You have 3 more. Try with this. Try with soil, chalk powder and 1 spoon milk. Okay, children, it is in your page number 64. You have to write, did it dissolve or not? Okay, for salt, it, yes, it dissolves. For soil, no, it does not dissolve. Okay, because soil is settled down at the bottom, and chalk powder, it is also settled down at the bottom. If spoon of milk, if 1 spoon of milk, yes, it dissolves with the water. And if it is oil, it floats on the surface of water. Okay, children, and then you have 3 more questions to discuss here. Could you see the salt after it dissolves in water? If no, why? Salt cannot be seen after it dissolves in water. This is because the salt is completely soluble in water. Okay, children, the second question. Does it mean that now the water does not have salt? If it has, then where is the salt? Answer, no, it does not mean that the water does not have salt. The salt is dissolved in water. Okay, children, this is about salt I have showed you in the activity. And also you have 2 more questions about chalk powder and salt. Okay, what they ask, children? To separate from the water by straining with a cloth, salt or chalk powder. What we can separate, children? We can separate the chalk powder by using the cloth. Okay, children, this is all about end of your activity. Try to do this in your home. Okay, children, thank you.